I'm teaching on the power of the blessing.
There
is power in the blessing.
You see,
I'm not talking about the blessings that ends with S.
I'm
talking about the power of the blessing without S. According to the Bible, he says in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, that we are called to inherit a blessing.
So we are
called. Tell somebody, I am called.
I am called.
To inherit.
To inherit.
A blessing.
The blessing.
I am called.
I am called
to inherit a blessing.
To inherit a blessing. Not just say ya tun sa fro se branebedi ade enhire bi a eda ho de ma o.
So you are blessed already.
Ni say nti we shira o dada we enhira.
And if you understand the power of the blessing,
say uti eye tumia ewo enhira ase a,
then you will begin to explode and expand. And I believe that today somebody will be expanded. The Bible made me to understand in Genesis chapter 39.
There
was this young man called Joseph.
The
Bible says he was a slave. But when he came to the house of Potiphar,
the
Bible said Potiphar could recognize that there is something on this young man that causes my house to expand. That causes my house to be blessed. But man of God, it is contradicting for a slave to make a master prosperous. So if a young man could make him prosperous, it means he is carrying the blessing. And so I don't care what you are selling or doing today. If you carry the blessing, you will expand and explode. Somebody will begin to expand. Somebody will begin to explode. If a slave can expand, then you who is not a slave, but a son of God, you are about to explode. You are about to expand. You are about to be increased. I see increase in your life. I see explosion in your life. Because of the blessing of God, we are called to inherit that blessing. And we have the blessing. The Bible said the man was died on the cross so that the blessing of
Abraham
may come on the Gentiles through them who believe. And because we believe, we have become the blessing of God. We have become the blessing of God. So whatever I do, I prosper. Whatever I do, I become a blessing. Whatever I do, I become a blessing. Today I declare and decree to you, whatever you do will prosper. Whatever you touch shall be blessed. Whatever you hold shall be blessed. Your business shall expand. Genesis chapter 1, it says, be fruitful and multiply. That is the DNA of a Christian. A Christian supposed to expand. If you're a Christian and you're not prospering, there is something wrong. Abraham was called to move out. And when he moved out, he became prosperous. Isaac became prosperous. Jacob became prosperous. Joseph became prosperous. We that are heir of God and joined heir with Christ, we also must be prosperous because we carry the blessing of God. May that blessing fall on you. May that blessing fall on you. May that blessing fall on you. The blessing is called Barak. When that Barak is on you, you explode and you expand. Today I see 10 people standing and expanding and exploding. Whatever they are doing is expanding. Whatever they are doing, they are exploding. In the name of Jesus. If you know you are the one, shout a big hallelujah.
See, as a child of God, you must not put before. No. In those days, they say Christianity is for poor people. No. Everyone in the Bible, from Abraham to the end, if you read the book of Hebrew, you will get to know that they were not just ordinary men. They take men, they take nations by storm. They took nations by storm. So my message, simple message is this. Understand that you are blessed. So that when you go to your work, when somebody is chanting and bringing certain things, you are carrying the blessing and you are speaking to your business. Because the blessing is in your mouth. The blessing is nowhere but in your mouth. So when you declare the word, it does not care what the weapons are. Because Bible said the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty to throw down or the pull down of strongholds. But you have a mouth that no weapon, form, fashion, design against you shall prosper. So you need to open your mouth wide and begin to speak the blessing. Declare the blessing. Say, my children will prosper. My job will expand. My ministry will explode. When you begin to speak those words, Bible says, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither has he entered into the heart of men the deep things that God has prepared for them that love him. So if you love God, you are already blessed. If you love God, you have been called into the blessing. And ladies and gentlemen, today I decree and declare that you will never live here the same. Something is coming your way. Something supernatural is coming your way. Blessing is coming your way. If you know that blessing is coming your way, the power of the blessing. Isaac became blessed. And the children of God, Bible said the Philistines envied him. Somebody is about to envy you. Because he prepares a table before you. In the presence of your enemies. There are many people who kill their enemies. But I don't kill my enemies. Because I need them to be at my table. Ah, he prepares the table before me in the presence of my enemies. And he anoints my head with oil. That anointing is called the blessing. That anointing is called takeover. When David understood the anointing, he was able to take over. And not just take over, he recollected all. Somebody is about to take over. And is about to take all. Because of the blessing of God. Bible said the blessing of God make it rich. And add no sorrow. If you are struggling, it's not the blessing of God. I came to announce to you, whatever curse has been met for you, today you are coming out with a blessing. That curse cannot stop you. If that curse stop your father, it cannot stop you. Do you understand what I'm saying? If you are yes, I receive it.
I receive it.
That curse cannot stop you. Man of God, God made me to understand this year I should preach only the blessing. I started teaching it from January till now. Miracles started happening. People began to understand. Money began to enter into people's pockets. The interesting part was when I went to Nigeria last month. I was preaching the same message. There was a blind woman behind the scene. As I was preaching the message, her eyes got opened. You don't understand the power that you carry. It's called the blessing that make it rich. Let me tell you today, all the rich men in the world are children of Israel.
Why?
Because they are connected to Abraham. Yes, still they are physical children of Abraham. But you and I are joined here with Christ. We should not be frustrated. You should not be frustrated. Somebody is coming to you. Somebody is visiting you with millions. As I was preaching in Nigeria, this same message. A crippled lady was sitting on a wheelchair. She waked up from the wheelchair. The same message. As I was preaching the same message, somebody with a deaf ear opened. I did not touch anybody. I just only told them the power of the blessing. What made Abraham, Abraham? What made Isaac, Isaac? And what made Joseph, Joseph in the foreign land?
Joseph, yeah, Joseph, ewa, mama,
but you are in this land that belongs to you. If the blessing can make him a prime minister, then the blessing in your land. I thank God for the election. But it's none of the president that will help you. The person that will help you is the blesser. And I see before the year will end. Before 31st, we have 13 days. 13 days. Somebody is receiving something. 13 days. I said somebody is receiving something. Your marriage in 13 days. Your miracle in 13 days. In the name of Jesus. Your visa in 13 days. I declare that by the power of God and the anointing in this house. I stand with the anointing in this house and I declare to you 13 days before the year will end, you have 3 millionaires in your church. I'm almost done preaching. If it's teaching, I will explain it. But let me tell you, if you know you are blessed, you will not be frustrated. When I get to my church, man of God, if you know Scandinavia, Scandinavia is one of the hardest countries. UK at least, they have a lot of churches there.
UK, and
other parts of Europe, good churches.
Europe,
but Scandinavia, they don't go to church. But when we enter there, and I started with my family, we were just about 5 years ago, I started calling the blessing. Every day when I stand on the pulpit, I say, I am blessed. I always tell them I can't fail in life. I am blessed. I am prosperous. I can't fail in life. I said, God will raise men and women in this church. But the church was empty. There were no people there. As I speak, they were coming. As I was declaring, they were coming. Men began to come. Ambassadors began to come. Ministers began to come. Directors of UN began to come. I said, the blessing of God make it rich. Bible said, God calleth those things which be not as though they were. Today I want to call forth. I say, from now to the end of this year, if God be for us, I said, from now, somebody will say it is a short time. But Prophet Elijah said, there's a tomorrow by this time, there will be food. But the man said, it is impossible. And the man said, it is impossible. And Elijah said, you will see it, but you not enjoy. I said, 13 days to go. God has given me the mandate to bless you. You are totally blessed. I said, you shall be blessed. You shall make it. And no spirit of death will come before you. You will see 31st all night. And you will be carrying your testimony. Somebody will be holding their testimony. On the day of 31st night. Somebody who had that business. Somebody, you have been going back and forth to your uncle. You have been going to your uncle's place for help, but they don't help you. Today they will help you. So you will receive a call today. Today you will receive a call, and that call will say, come, let me help you. I declare that in the name of Jesus. I declare that in the name of Jesus. If you are yes, I receive it.
I receive it.
Somebody say, but where is it written in the New Testament? Well, let me prove
it.
Galatians chapter 3. From verse 11. Christ has redeemed us. Uh-huh.
Galatians 3:11.
Yes.
But that no one is justified by the law.
Yes.
Justified by the law in the sight of God is evident.
Yeah.
For the just shall live by faith.
Yes.
Yet the law is not of faith.
Uh-huh.
But the man who does them shall live by
them. By them, yes.
Verse 13. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law.
He has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Let me tell you something. He didn't say he has redeemed us from the curse of the ground. He said the curse of the law. So the curse of the ground is still operating. When he pronounced curse on Adam, he says that you shall be cursed above all. And he said with sweat you shall sweat to eat. That is why men think they can sweat to get money. It is not that one. You cannot just be working hard to get money. It is the blessing that makes you get it. So he
said
he redeemed us from the curse of the law. But the curse of the ground is still operating. So how can I live above the curse of the ground?
It's
called the power of the blessing. When Jesus got to Peter, Peter said, we have stalled all night and we have caught nothing. But he said, but by your word. But by your word. I will lay down my nets. By your word. What was that word? It was the blessing. When he laid down the nets, because Jesus spoke the blessing, the fish began to enter into the nets. So though he taught all night, but it took a word from the prophet Jesus. Today is taking a word from you. Just a word today. That you are blessed. See, when I greet you, it's not a greeting. You know, man of God, we used to say, how are you? Says, fine, I'm blessed. And people think it's a greeting. No. What are you talking about? And that's why we never get blessed. Let me tell you, if your father gives you $1 million and you don't carry the blessing, nothing will work. But if your father can give you just words, just words, it does not matter where you go, you will make it. Somebody will make it. 2017 is the year you will make it. I said 2017 is the year you will make it. Give five people a high five and say, I'll make it. I'll make it. It's a blessing. I'll make it. The musicians, get ready. I'll make it. Hallelujah. I'll make it. The blessing make it rich. The blessing maketh rich. The blessing maketh rich. The blessing maketh rich. Somebody is becoming rich now. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I am done with my message. And what I said was the power of the blessing. Whenever you, whatever you do, know you are blessed. And then bring that mindset into what you are doing. And you'll see the fruitfulness of that. If you can sell an ice water and you make it. Many people think that it's about having huge capital. When you have the blessing, whatever you touch it will begin to explode. When my father died in 2010, that's when I was starting my ministry. My father sent me a text message 2 days before he died. He said, my son, I was the third born. But he sent me, say, my son, you'll be blessed among the others.
He
said, whatever you tell them, you to become. My father was not a pope or bishop.
My papa not a pope, not a bishop.
He was not even a pastor.
Not
a pope. He's not even take God seriously.
Serious.
But his words today are working in my life. He said, my son, you'll make it in any land you are. He said, any land you get to, you'll make it.
He
said, you'll be so blessed. When he said that to me, I did not understand it. Because I didn't know he was going to die, because nothing shows that he was going to die. 2 days later, they called me from Denmark.
Say,
he's gone. I said, what? I had my brothers and my sisters around. So I deleted the message. I don't want them to see. No. They will envy me. I just cut it off. And today is working. The blessing maketh rich. Our ministry, we don't struggle to do things. They know it. My ministry, we don't struggle. Mention the amount we need. I go to my office. I say, the God that blesses Jacob, Isaac, Abraham. Bring your money in. Within 2 days, somebody brings it.
We don't struggle.
We don't struggle to do things. We do it so cheap. We do it so cheap. Sweatless ministry. No, sweatless. I just sit in my office and declare, and it just happened. Sweatless ministry. Sweatless life in your life. Touch that place right now. I want to pray. I feel the healing anointing here right now. The healing anointing is here right now. I told you, we do things without sweat. Father, heal them right now. Pain, go. Pain, disappear. Never to come back. Headache, go! Stomach problem, go! Diabetes, go! Eyesight, go! In the name of Jesus, I decree that you have no place in their bodies. Therefore, go right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Pain is gone. Check yourself, it's gone. Check yourself, it's gone.
Send your word. It's gone.
And healed.
It's gone. 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 I know it's gone. I know it's gone. I know it's gone. If you were sick and you felt something left you come out. Just come out. I know it's gone. Just come out. Just come out. Don't deceive me. Just come out. Just come. If it's not gone, stand there. But if it's gone, just come out. Just come out. Just come out. Because I know that the pain is gone. But as you come in to testify, you'll find out that it's no longer there. Even if you're not here, come, let me touch you. It will be gone.
Yes.
You could talk like a man so that you hear you.
I had neck pain.
So yes.
Yeah. But now I can.
You can turn your head. Turn it. Turn it. Turn it. Do you feel any pain? It's totally gone. You are healed.
In the name of.
Who can sing this song? Miracle. Great make. Is it waymaker or whatever they call it? Man of God, I'll just finish up and then I'll give it to you. Shout it with your voice. Okay?
You are here, moving in amaze.
Thank you, Jesus.
I worship you.
Where you are standing, look at yourself. You will find out that your pain is gone. That sickness is gone. That sickness is gone. I don't care whether it's diabetes, whatever. And just come forward when you feel that. Thank you, Lord. I worship you.
I worship you. I worship you. Hey, waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Hey, waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper.
What?
Ulcers on my ankles.
Your ankles.
And it was very painful.
When you were coming, it was very painful.
Yeah, that's what it has calmed down.
It has calmed down. Just stand there. I want to check your leg. Huh? What was your challenge? Just stand there.
Pain both sides of my stomach.
Both sides of your stomach. You say when I was praying, you felt some cold. That's the anointing of the blessing. Hallelujah. You are permanently healed. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Next. Yes. Yes. You feel better. Throats. Don't come back again. Curse you. Out. Be free. In Jesus' name. Amen. I felt that you have pain in your hands. Come. If you have pain in your hands, come. Come. I'm a healing minister, so that's why. Come. You feel the pain still in your hands. Here. Jesus, be healed. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. It's done. Now do what you couldn't do with the hand. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Go, go, Do it. You're a gentle lady. Do it. In the name of Jesus. Are you feeling pain? You're not feeling pain. Don't deceive me. Are you feeling pain? You're not feeling pain. It's gone. You are healed permanently. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yeah? Your hand. Where? Your ribs. Jesus, the fire of the Holy Spirit. The fire of the Holy Spirit. Thank you. You are healed. It's done. No, wait. Thank you, God. Turn your back. Bend. No, bend. Bend. You see, your problem is not your hand, it's your waist. And you see, sometimes, because I'm a doctor myself, sometimes when somebody comes to you for healing, you need to descend. Sometimes somebody can have chest pain, but he will feel headache. So the sickness is more than just the headache. You are free.
What do you home?
Because of that, your hand will be okay. Lift it up and do what you couldn't do. Do you feel it? You feel it? It's totally gone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lastly, come. You say, what happened to you? You had on your ankle. Power of the Holy Spirit. Receive the healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Receive your healing. Pain, go! In Jesus' name. Amen. It's gone. The ulcers and whatever it is gone. It will never come back again. No pain again. Are you with me? No pain again. God bless you. Congratulations. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. I want to bless you before I go. What is the challenge? Do you feel
can help?
Hallelujah. I can help you. So don't sit down with it. God has given me that healing grace. So I know. What is your challenge? Your bones. Every part of your body. Wow. Be healed. Totally free. You devil of darkness, never to return back. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You devil of darkness, never to return back. Go. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Shake your hands. Shake your body. Do what you couldn't do. Yeah, they aren't me yet. Why? Go to Kakri, go to Ne. Exercise. Hey, it's okay. Are you telling me the truth? Don't look at them. You can tell me. You see, when Jesus touched somebody and then he asked him, what do you see? The person said, I see men like trees. Jesus said, you need a second touch. So it won't be, I will not be the first person to touch somebody second. Are you with me? Yeah, so don't lie to me. When it's not there, it's not there. When Jesus touched somebody, he said, I see men like trees. Jesus said, this is the whole anointed man. He says, I see men like trees. How much more me? A vessel that he used. So I can touch you 10 times. You understand? So don't lie to me. Are you okay? God bless you. What is your challenge? Can I have you? No, put it where the pain is. By the power of the Holy Spirit, be totally gone. Jesus, no paralyzed. Spirit of paralyzed, I cast you. Chest pain, I cast you. Out. Be free. Totally free. Totally free. In Jesus' name. Amen. I breathe the breath of the Spirit on you. Holy Spirit, thank you. Check it right now. How are you feeling? You can no, don't lie to me. And that damn it. Can't be sad, be sad. Yeah. Can't. Our mic. Echo, what is echo? Yedenyamiasi. Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. What is wrong? Severe headache. For the last 3 days. Oh, I can see. For the last 3 days, you devil of darkness. Out. Headache. Go. In Jesus' name. You see, drink more water too, eh? How are you feeling now? You are better now. Totally gone. Whomever the man sets free is free indeed. Whomever Jesus set free is totally free. Amen. Just drink water more. Today drink almost like 3 liters. And you're done. What is your challenge here? Your eye. What is wrong with you? It's always turning. Always turning. You can't look far. You can't see far. So, Holy Spirit. Somebody say, I can't think far. I can't look far. I can't. I don't think far. Thank you, Jesus. Be free.
Breathe this. Just breathe in. Breathing out. Breathing out.
All right. Now, close. Open your eyes.
Yeah, when you...
Close these eyes. Open this one. Can you? Can you see my fingers?
Who knows, sir?
That's what I said now. Can you see my fingers? All right. Close this one. Somebody put one hand. No, you put one hand. Okay, now open your eyes. Don't use this one. Can you see my fingers? How many are they?
Hallelujah.
Good. Stand where you are. Where? Close. 3. Were you able to see after this distance?
Yes.
You were able to see formally?
Yes.
3.
Yes.
All right. I need a very long distance. Now, where you stand, don't turn. Because if you have a good sight, even when you look at this, you can see. Okay? One. What did you say? You couldn't see. I thought you said one. Okay? You can't. All right. Father, thank you. Thank you. That's a good song. Now close it again. Totally healed. You are totally healed. You couldn't read your Bible. Could you read your Bible? Not that much. So go and take that same Bible. Rest, read it now. Okay? Go and bring it. You have your Bible with you. In the Sunday school. Get my Bible, please. Open anywhere you want to. Seeing with this eye, it's choking, it hurts. That's a different thing. If you say you cannot see, it's a different thing. Look far, but it always choke you. It hurts. Test in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The pain, go, never to come back. In Jesus' name. You are free. You are free. You are free. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Be on your feet, please. Be on your feet, please. I want to bless you. Jesus.